Remember, you're still gonna be you on vacation. If you are sad where you are, and then you get on a plane to Italy, to you in Italy will be the same sad you from before, just in a new place. Does that make sense?
Corridors, 28 elevators, trapdoor, and imagine hundreds of slaves just working on the backstage. So this was the backstage inside the scenes of Colosseum. And imagine, like in the video, JW.org, 80,000 people just screaming.
And they were keeping all the treatment on.
They had elevators back then. Isn't that crazy?
Because at that time, they died very young. The average life of a man was 38. The average life of a woman, 29. 29 years for a woman. Because 60% of them died pregnant because of the infections, because of the disease. That's why when they were 15, they were allowed to fight. 16, they got married. 17, they had children. 25, it's like now, 45, 50.
Moreover, so it's not like with big muscles like the WWE stars of US. It's very natural and it's super short. Why? Because the people back then were not like very, they were super short. Imagine the average height of a man was 1.68 meters. Of a woman, 1.57 meters. So we would be considered like six giants in the ancient Rome.
Wow.
Because the people were super short. Moreover, they had always a big belly, because there were no special supplements for artificial muscles.
Guys, how many died in the Colosseum in 450 years of games? Because the Colosseum was used for 450 years. What do you think? How many people died for fun, for entertainment?
Our Hayden Christensen film Jumper.
Oh dear.
So this is standing on the top of the floor. Look.
No, they will not be nautilus standing. But this is a very clever question. The archaeologists understood that the seats of the Colosseum were inclined of 37 degrees to have a great view from everywhere. So imagine that Roman, well, the Jewish engineers, they were calculating the seats, just for giving an incredible picture of the view. Unreal. And now, my friends, maybe you are thinking, but where the seats are? Because I don't see the cameras. Exactly. That's why they use the elevator. Super. So guys, imagine. Arena, 80,000 people, women, slaves, and children standing on the top. And here, just the people walking into the corridor to find their place. Welcome into the wonderful Colosseum, young people, Flavius. Eddie, Kylie, please come here. Look, the advertising is that one, the white marble one. That is the Coca-Cola sponsor. The letters were all painted in red, but the red color is gone because of the air pollution. So the advertising, the only one, prayer station, the prayer faith chapel that was made by the Pope just to convince the pilgrims that this was the place where the martyrs died. The fake bronze cross, because as I told you, the Colosseum was finally included in the list of the holy places. And here, arena, underground, and the trapdoor on your left.
Oh, that was, there was a floor.
Of course, it was a flat floor.
Right above.
Here's your trapdoor.
Yes, so right above.
We'd be actually pretty close if you stood right there.
You wouldn't see anything in the underground.
Is this where the emperor would sit?
That was the last.
Oh, kind of like in soccer stadiums.
Yeah, like in a soccer stadium. Yeah, yeah. As always. So it's incredible. They were just imitating the Romans. Yeah.
The eighth.
You've heard of the afterlife? Everybody knows that.
Yes.
Have you heard of it?
The famous arch that is mentioned by this is the pop-up. The picture from Rome. Why? Because this is the arch celebrating Constantine's life. Constantine is the one who legalized the Catholicism, as we have learned yesterday in the Vatican, in the 312. But it's also the man of the lies, because the Vatican is still sending lots of lies regarding Constantine, as we have learned yesterday in the Vatican tour. They say Constantine is Catholic, Constantine wasn't Catholic at all. Constantine was baptized in St. Peter Church when he was young. St. Peter, he wasn't new yet. Constantine wasn't baptized when he was young. They say Constantine is a great family man on the arch. Constantine, the Watchtower 98 says he was an assassin. He was an assassin. He killed his wife, his son, and four of his grandchildren. Why? Because the Roman people were used to drink water from the lead pipes. And the lead, damaged the brain. That's why so many Roman people were completely crazy. Julius Caesar, Caligula, Constantine, Nero, too much lead in their brain. That's why when they say to you, Constantine, great man, don't forget the word at all. Constantine, it's really a monster, but they do not want to say this because Constantine is the ruler of the Catholics.
I am
this
traumatized.
This is an original toilet at the Colosseum.
You didn't do your history homework.
I did.
Gross back then. You don't want to go back in time.
The bell tower of the church.
Wow.
Exactly the same height.
Oh, no way.
La parte di là in realtà si entrava, si scendeva da dove siamo entrati. Era la prima volta, invece da poi siamo andati
sotto. Ti dico, io a Catania, che piazza sta figura? Non ti sotterrare, è una cosa.
Ich habe nicht gedacht, dass sie direkt auf der Leiche
This is the birthhouse of the Emperor Augustus. Moreover, Augustus and Tiberius, they fulfilled an amazing Daniel prophecy. Why? Because 600 years in advance, Daniel said, at the very beginning, the history of the King of the North, one ruler will be honored, and his successor will be despised. The honored one is Augustus, that is still considered like the father of Roman culture, and the despised one is Tiberius, because like in such scripture book, remember, Tiberius has been the first and the last emperor of Rome who wasn't deified. Why? Because Tiberius was homosexual and pedophile. That's why when he died, the senators refused to deify him. The Daniel's prophecy fulfilled.
Now they have been hidden from your eyes. Because the days will come upon you when your enemies will build around you a fortification of pointed stakes and will encircle you and besiege you from every side. They will dash you and your children within you to the ground, and they will not leave a stone upon a stone in you, because you do not discern the time of your being inspected.
The second part of the prophecy, my brothers, was in the chapter 21 of Luke. Thanks, Eddie. Let's go ahead again. Chapter 21 of Luke, from the verse 20 to 22.
Nearby, you can see the chief citizens of the state who, with their presence, honored conqueror.
So the VIP of Rome celebrating Titus when he came back from Jerusalem with all the bounty.
If you look on the left wall, you will see the richest spoils of the Jerusalem temple, such as the menorah, the golden lampstand, the table of showbread, the sacred trumpets, and the signs with names of the captured cities, and the gate of the most holy. That is the gate of the most holy.
Wow.
Jehovah's temple. Right, right.
So, this is today, and now you will see the biggest temple of Rome was this one. Tardon, look.
Wow.
You are right here in the middle of it. Now you will see. And the floor is the original one from the nearest house, 2,000 years. It's not the replica.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Here. They're taking pictures of floors.
No, not here.
Just now you will amazing. See.
Tardon, look. Is this the original floor of the Nero's house?
Wow.
Is the best preserved floor in the ancient city. And look at the columns, the red columns are all original too. So they were just reused from the Nero's bedroom. It is not crazy.
Nero was crazy.
Imagine the Roman city.
The
Roman
was dope.
Last frame.
Right there, after we visited the main. Let it go social. Don't lose it. They don't trip.
But yeah, if you dig, you have that apple juice.
For learning. The archaeologists of Rome must still at work, cleaning every single stone. My dear brothers, in front of you, another intact original mausoleum of 1,700 years. This is the mausoleum where inside there was the body of the son of the Emperor Maxentius, the one we met in the Raphael's room fighting against Constantine. Look, the reconstruction is this. Imagine people doing sacrifices publicly. Because the sacrifices were always done publicly. Because the people, they want to be seen, like today. Marketing, okay? So imagine people leaving on that table animals, zeros, grain, and many other donations. Do you know how that table was used to be called? DonariumDonate.org. That's why when we say donarium, we are still calling the table of the demons. This was in Paul's day. Ta-da-dum. The honorific columns and the courthouse, the supreme court, not a common court. Mm-hmm. This was the court only for people with citizenship.
Oh, okay.
Ah.
Which Paul had, yeah.
That's why when the Bible say I appeal to Caesar, it means I appeal to this, to the great tribunal of Rome. The only one supreme court for people with citizenship. Mm-hmm. Imagine Paul coming right here and just listening in a 65 for the dead sentence. Paul appealed to Caesar because he was a Roman citizen. That's why when Paul said, I appeal to Caesar, he was saying, I would like to be judged, not in Israel, but in the Supreme Court of Rome, because I have the citizenship. And they were scared. They said, what? You have the citizenship? And he said, yes, I was born as a Roman. And one of the soldiers was kidding him. He said, did you buy the citizenship? He said, no, I was born. Because there were people ready to pay. The colonies, some of them. Imagine inside of it. Do you remember how many golden coins?
So we are at the world famous crowd of people. Sorry. The Trevi Fountain. What makes this fountain special? Nothing. It's just that people throw their money into it.
That's not why it's special. It's special because look at it.
Oh, it's amazing. It's fantastic. Absolutely breathtaking. I'm glad it's well lit this time of day. No, so you stand with your back to the fountain, and you throw a coin over your shoulder for a wish to to return to Rome. Okay. Wish to return to Rome. 2 coins for finding love. And 3 coins
to get married.
To get married and to have a title of a good movie.
Yeah.
3 coins in the bank, which was a pretty decent movie. Roman Holiday was better. The only thing 3 coins had over Roman Holiday 3 coins was in color.
Yeah.
And a movie about Rome really needs to be in color. It really
very colorful does. City.
Very colorful city. Just gorgeous. You could probably colorize Roman Holiday with today's technology. It would look great.
I have my picture down here.
Okay.
We are here at the Pantheon at night, and I cannot begin to explain how huge this building is. I mean, I feel it's massive. Here we go. Here's the whole room. This is our hotel in Rome. It's like a kind of a bed and breakfast kind of thing.
Make sure you subscribe and click the bell to join us for the next episode.